Hey, what's up guys, it's Tikosaur. A while ago, I made a video about how a 90mm tablet cooler performed on the ROG Ally. Since then, I've received some requests from Legion Go users asking about how this cooler would fare on the Legion Go. So in this video, we'll explore if it's actually worth having. So let's get started. I'll be installing it in the area that typically gets the hottest, right around the Z1 Extreme chip. To install it, it comes with this magnetic plate that will be sticked to the back and then mount the cooler magnetically. A downside to this big cooler is the inability to use the kickstand anymore, because the occupied space of it reaches the hinge area, hindering the ability to open the kickstand. And additionally, the cooler has two speed settings, one quiet and the other one at maximum speed. And it also has this screen that you can see the current surface temperature. Now let's get started with some benchmarks with cooler on maximum speed on those three different power limits. And for this test, I'll be using STAPM as a thermal policy. If you are unsure what that means, check out my other suggested video here to understand the difference between STAPM and STT on Legion Go thermal policies. So at 15 and 20 watt, we see no significant difference in scores. But at 30 watt, we got a small increase in CPU score with the cooler installed, about 250 points. Now running 3DMark time spy stress test at 30 watt, we noticed some temperature drop about 2.5 degrees for CPU, but most notably the SSD temperature managed to drop by 7 degrees. I've also run it on CINEBENCH and here we got again some multi-core score uplift in all three scenarios. Checking temperature at 15 watt, we see a 2 degrees drop in CPU temperature, and SSD this time got a 5 degrees drop. Switching to 20 watt, we see the most temperature drop in the SSD by 6 degrees. Finally, at 30 watt, we observe a 2 degrees drop across all components. So in conclusion, based on my experience with it, the cooler may indeed help cool down the Legion Go, but given the lack of direct contact with the chip heat spreader, there's a limit to its cooling capacity. Otherwise, it's really a very good cooler. Perhaps if someone can modify the back cover to house it closer to the chip bracket, it will surely drop temperatures even much more. I might try it as well, so please let me know in the comments if you would be interested to see that. I thank you for watching. As always, if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up to help in the algorithm. And subscribe to Tikosaur to stay updated on future content. Thanks for watching and see you on the next one.